All right, Coach. Eve of the MAC tournament. I'm gonna you got the coaches meeting coming up here. I don't know what goes on there. You already got the seeds, but some odd seeds to me, Coach, that I saw, and I don't know if you could help shed some light on it, but 149. Tywan Claxton wins the head-to-head, but the number one guy in the country is the two seed. Can you explain that to me?
I totally disagree with it. I'm one of the few coaches that didn't want it that way. It's kind of funny you're asking me because I was one of the guys arguing. Actually, it was me and Doug Schwab thought I don't understand it. I think it not only screws up the 1 and 2 seed, but it screws up who they wrestle their first match, and it also screws up the 3 and 4 guy. You know, he beat him early on, and I guess that's more important than being number one guy in the country. I don't know.
97, same thing. Jaden Cox.
Exact same thing.
Jaden Cox, Phil, but they both won the head-to-heads. They both beat the guys their seed.
They did, but that was back in December when Clint Cox was it was his first dual match ever. They started at 197. It's his hometown. You know, like you said, he's ranked second in the country now for a reason. We got in arguments. I actually fought, and it was a huge, huge argument because if you go by the criteria, I fought for my guy to get the fourth seed, and it was a huge ordeal on the seeding meeting because they had my guy the third seed, but he lost to the Northern Illinois guy head-to-head. I think ultimately, if you look, you know, I think everyone thinks that my guy's the third best guy, but I fought him for to get the fourth seed. I literally was fighting to get
the lower better draw
seed.
Because it's a so better...
it's
away from Huddleshell.
It's a better... This is 197. That one I couldn't fight because De Palma didn't wrestle the guy who was the fourth seed, but I wanted the same thing. I think, those are two best guys in the country, and they're the number one and two in the country, and they're the two seeds here. It doesn't make any sense to me, but I got in an argument with the coach. I was pretty adamant about it because we followed this criteria, which I don't think the criteria is the correct way to do it. And my guy ended up getting the fourth seed, which they originally had him the third seed. And I said, no, we have to follow the first two criterias. And went round and round, and they wanted to vote on it. And I said, what are we voting for? We have criteria. We got to follow the criteria. And ultimately, I think I held it up long enough where everyone just kind of laughed it off and gave my guy the fourth seed. But you know, like I said, it screws up the whole It screws up the whole tournament at that weight class if you don't see people right. And something I think our conference needs to take a look at. On paper, we're the second best conference in the country, and we can't get our guys seated in the right place, in my opinion. Look at the Big Ten. I think Stiebert lost to the Penn State guy, right?
Yeah.
What's he seated?
He's the one seed.
He's the one seed. You know, it's just, you know, we got to get the guys that are the best guys seated 1, 2, 3, 4 in order. So everyone else falls in line to make the seeds the right way. If not, let's not seed 7 people.
Not having Sam Wheeler, it's something huge to overcome. When you think about not having Sam Wheeler, how bad does it hurt you, and can you overcome it?
I think as a program, or as a team, we've moved forward. I think as a program, I've had to answer a lot of questions. I've moved forward with it. It hurts, though. It hurts. You know, kids have 4 chances to do this, and he just lost a chance to do it. I think his RPI ranking was 5th, maybe, at 184. I think he was ranked like 10th, maybe, somewhere in that area. So on paper, he's the second best guy on our team, and we lost him. And like I said last week to you, it's a valuable lesson for our team, for our athletic department, because, you know, I'm going to make sure that this follows par as far as if something else happens like this with on our campus, because, you know, like I said, we took a guy's season away, and I'm just following orders.
All right, Coach. 33, 41, 49, 57, 65, you got a chance. 74 is a guy who should definitely be there. 84, you're out, I think, on that one. 97, I think all those weights I just named, but 84, all those guys can qualify. What do they got to do here to qualify?
I think we just got to take it match by match. You know, we got guys that are already looking forward to, you know, their second match, their what's going to happen here, if they lose and what happens. And I think you just have to take it match by match, and you have to, you know, I know there's a guy, a top seeded kid that's hurt. You know, I know because I've heard from different people. You never know what's going to happen here, and it's a hard tournament, and, you know, it got harder by adding Missouri, Northern Iowa, and Old Dominion. So anything can happen. I think last year, first round, they're like, literally 3 upsets in the first round, major upsets. I think the OU guy upset the Central Michigan guy at 125 last year. So you just got to wrestle, and you got to treat, you know, I think our guys are feeling good. I think that they've grown so much. We're a young team. We got one junior, the rest are freshmen and sophomore on our team, and they've grown throughout the year. We've made a lot of mistakes, and we've done a lot of bad wrestling at times. But all in all, I think our guys have really, really grown throughout the year, and I think that they're, you know, I'll take our schedule against anyone's in the country as far as the toughness of it. And because of that, a lot of our guys have a very high RPI ranking. And I just tell them, I say, listen, you know, our schedule was way harder than a lot of these kid teams here. And let's just go out there and wrestle like we've wrestled against the Northern Iowas, the Iowa States, the Ohio State when we wrestled them. The Virginias, the Virginia Tech that we tied twice or lost one time in overtime. So we just have to go out and wrestle. We have to wrestle very, very well to give any of our guys a chance.
Is the number one seed that's hurt your number one seed?
No. Ian Miller, you know, we have one number one seed. He's as healthy as he's ever going to be at this point in the year. Like I said, I don't think his arm's even a factor. I just think, you know, it's like, you know, it's, at this point, if anyone's 100% healthy, they probably didn't have a very hard schedule, or they might have had some time off during the year. But at this point in the year, everyone's a little bit banged up, and he's a little banged up. But his arm hasn't felt any. This is the best it's felt since he hurt it, and he's ready to go. He's excited. I think I'm excited for him because he's probably been wrestling his best that I've seen him wrestle in the room all year.
Coach, there's one thing you guys need to do. I keep taking you and guys, you and Buffalo out of the equation. I say you and Buffalo can't win it.
Yeah.
What do you got to do to be right there if you want to be a second or even sneak in and win?
I think for us to have any chance at all to win this tournament, we need to wrestle our best, and we need some other teams to, you know, we need the Buffaloes and Eastern Michigans to upset some guys and Northern Illinois guys to upset some guys, so maybe we could squeeze in a spot somewhere. Missouri's good. Northern Iowa's good. Those two teams are very good. Old Dominion, they're probably wrestling the best in the conference at the end of the year. They're good. We beat them in a dual meet. You know, we talked about seedings and everything. We wrestled Old Dominion here in December, and I think we beat them 7-3. We beat them easily. And where they're at now, they're a much better team now than they were back in December.
I don't think you'd have a chance to beat them in a duel right now. Well, that's just my opinion.
I'm not arguing with you, but that's why as a tournament you need to make sure everyone's seated right. But anything can happen. I think that I still think that, you know, if you go match to match against
Old Dominion.
Like I said, how much are things going to change? I don't know. We'll find out. I like the way that Caleb Marsh is wrestling it right now. It's the best he's ever looked in a Kent State singlet in his 3 years here. So, you know, that's one person. I think Tyler Small, you know, he's been in the finals of this tournament twice. I know the tournament's different now, but the kid knows how to win. And that's something you can't teach. I can't teach a young kid how to win. That's something you have to just do. And he's won this tournament. He's also taken second. And if there's any guy that you can't count out, it's a guy like Tyler Small. Like I said, I know he's it's one of the tougher weight classes here, but he's the fourth or the fifth seed. He wrestles a guy that I think he can wrestle with. After that, he wrestles the one seed. I don't think that weight class is one of those weight classes where this guy's that much better than anyone else. And like I said, you play your hand and see how the way the card is dealt. You play your hand and see how it goes. But I think that we got a lot of guys that can wrestle through this tournament. And like I said, it's a qualifier. That's one thing you have to remember. This is a qualifier to reach your goal. And it isn't the end all be all. Yeah, you want to win as a team. But the bottom line is, this is almost where it becomes an individual thing too. Like, you know, I got to make sure that Ian Miller isn't going out there and trying to score points to get our team points up. Just he goes out there and takes care of his business and gets off the mat, goes, relaxes, and worries about Ian Miller. And Ian Miller isn't worrying about DePalma or the guy above him at this point. Because, like you said, I think Ian Miller wants to win a national championship. If something were to happen here, I think his goal is still going to be win a national championship. So we have to individually look at guys and just hope that they can do the best.